I welcome you all to my today's session, Branding. In today's competitive world of marketing, a key to business success is building a strong brand. Brand is the way your customer perceives you. Strong brand increases profitability, it builds customer loyalty, it provides protection to the business in its turbulent times. Now let me take you through what is branding. Before discussing what is branding, let us see the basic difference between what a brand and a product is. A product is any offering by a company to a market that serves to satisfy customer needs and wants. A product can be an object, service, idea, etc. It means that it is the bundle of benefits which is put together to satisfy consumer needs. Whereas, on the other hand, a name becomes a brand when consumers associate with a set of tangible and intangible benefits that they obtain from the product or service. Thus, it means that brand is the seller's promise to deliver the same bundle of benefit or services consistently to buyers. Therefore, brands are not the same as products. Thus, branding is a process which involves creating a specific name, logo, and an image of a particular product, service, or company. This is basically done to attract customers. It is usually done through advertisements with a consistent theme built around. Let us see the history or the origins of branding. Branding, the word brand, is derived from an old Norse word which means to burn, which refers to the practice of branding livestock, wherein they used to use a hot iron rod which is actually heated and put on the skin of the livestock to show that particular symbol as well as to show that the livestock belongs to theirs. Branding livestock is much older than 400 years, dated back to the Indus Valley civilizations. Similarly, farmers used branding to claim their properties. Artisans used it to claim credit for their work. And companies started using it to claim products better than the competitors. Evidences have shown that the paintings in the rocks during the Stone Age had cattle which were drawn in the rocks with the symbols or brands on its body, which were painted with paint and tar. Or other ways, they used to use the burning iron which is permanently marked on the skin. Egyptian funeral monument also shows that over 400 years old paintings or 400 years old monuments depicted branded cattle. Potteries which were made in China, India and Greece and Rome also use 1,000 unique type of brands in their pottery making. We could also find signs on the bricks which were used for constructions. In the later part, printing houses and paper makers used watermarks as a way of branding their things. Similarly, during Industrial Revolution, another type of branding called as mass branding were used for solving business problems. Winemakers also use certain logos on barrels to differentiate their barrels from that of other manufacturers. On the later 18th century, Americans used in various products like soups, beverages. One such soup is what is your Campbell's soup, and Coca-Cola also started using brands for their beverages. In the 19th century, companies also started using slogans, mascots. They also had jingles to advertise their products in radio and television. Now let's quickly see what is a brand, what it means to the consumer. For them, it is the trust or the strong technology, as well as it means what they love. When it comes to brands like Nokia, is known for its trust and strong technology among Indian consumers. Similarly, Starbucks people have earned a brand image wherein people feel the flavor to be more bolder and they love the coffee and the place where they have the coffee. Similarly, there are also other brands like Audi, Wrangler, where people feel highly associated with. From these examples, we can make out that brand is actually a promise that the product will perform as per the customer expectations. Now, here comes the definition of brand. Let us quickly see that it is a name, term, sign, symbol, or a combination of all these which differentiates the goods or services of one seller or group of sellers from those of competitors. So some of the strongest brand which resides in consumers' mind are the examples which I have given in the slides. Why does it really matter for a company? Why does brand matter? So here we see the reasons for why brand matters. So it is actually acting as a growth driver for an organization. It is an unspoken promise of value. It is actually how a product will perform according to the customer expectations. Brand also makes a sense of differentiation of their goods or services from others in the marketplace. It also represents what the company stands for or its offerings. It has a high emotional connect with the customers. In addition to that, brand, does it mean status according to Mercedes, or does it really care for environment like Panasonic, or is it providing an elegant and refined look like Omega, or does it mean to say it is rugged like Royal Enfield, or is it sporty and loving outdoors like Nike, or is it an open-minded progressive thing like Apple, or is it achievement-oriented people using Lenovo brands, or the quality which is offered by Blue Star. So there are plenty of examples wherein which depicts the expectations of customer and what it means to them. Thus, people are really connected emotionally with a brand and they feel that it is important to them. And at the same time, they also try to show that it is the brand which depicts them. It is used to express themselves. And they also feel that they remain loyal to the brand for which they advocated to others also. So brand conscious customers are really not price sensitive and thus serving as an asset for a company. Now let's see the characteristics of successful brand. So having seen a plenty of examples, here again I would like to tell you the characteristics which are shared by successful brands. So they tend to offer superior product quality. They offer additional services apart from the general performance attributes that they provide. Brands are helping to differentiate themselves and their offerings from other competitors. They act in their own way, pioneers in their way of conducting business, and they try to follow a long-term communication strategy which helps them to reside in consumers' mind. Having been seeing the characteristics of successful brand, let me now move on to what does a brand communicate. Now, a brand communicates all these points. It includes attributes, benefits, value, culture, personality, and target user. Here, in this presentation, I would like to give you a quick glance of the brand Horlicks. Horlicks, when we say Horlicks, the first thing that would come to our mind is the nourishment, which people use it as a health drink and they love the great taste it gives, and it is a malt drink. So the core identity of the brand, if you see, is a food drink which is healthy, which is tasting great. The attribute that you can associate with the brand is the smart nutrients present in it, the flavors, the malt content, and of course the great taste. Now, what is the benefit out of drinking this? People get energy, they feel enthusiastic. It is actually advocated to all the family members. And then when you talk about values, it satisfies the nutritional needs for decades. So people have been using this brand for more than 50 years. And if you see the relationship built the entire family, starting from the children, the nursing mothers, and of course you have the brand which is for the elder people also. And then talking about the culture, we generally used to give Horlicks to people whom we feel we are loved, you know, they are loved. So we tend to give this Horlicks to people for nourishment, for care and love and affection. So the personality type here is, we are talking about protecting, caring. You tend to be very supportive to that people. You tend to be concerned about them. So for them, you tend to give this product. And the value or the target user which you can give is, the target user, as I told you in the beginning itself, it includes all the person in the family, you know, right from the small children till the old people in the house can consume this particular product. So the value that the company tries to position among consumers is, it is a healthy drink as well as it is helping people to remain active and do their job better. So with this note, I would like to conclude my session on introduction to branding. See you in my next topic, which is branding concepts.